What does a plant-based, whole foods, cancer-kicking breakfast look like? Hi, my name's Nick from Naturally Nick, and I'm a cancer survivor myself, a dietitian of nearly 30 years, and I now help women optimize their health after cancer. And what I want to be talking about is what does an optimal breakfast look like? So after you've woken up and you have drunk 500 mils, possibly a whole liter of water in that first hour of waking, with maybe a dash of apple cider vinegar or a squeeze of lemon juice just to flush out your system and rehydrate yourself on waking. We want to be having a breakfast that is going to provide us with lots of sustaining nutrients. And I love to try and get green into every single meal. And that can be a little bit challenging for breakfast. Especially if you're not having, if you don't want a green smoothie. So I've come up with a little bit of a play on the green smoothie because I like a green smoothie, but I also like to eat my breakfast. So what I do is I make a green smoothie and then I add some of the other ingredients that I want to add to it. So let's start with the basics. Making just a basic green smoothie. So starting with something green, I'm going to add a kale leaf. Now, a kale leaf might be just a little bit hardcore if you're starting out. If you're starting out, and this is the first time you're doing anything like this, I would start with something which is a little less hardcore, like maybe some baby spinach, or even sometimes if all I can get organic, I do try and eat organic wherever I possibly can, when it's financially viable or I can source it. So sometimes it's just a couple of sticks of celery and a banana. Today I am going to do the kale leaf and a banana, or you could be doing baby spinach leaves. Sometimes if you've got some gorgeous cos lettuce in the garden. Other times if I'm traveling and all I can find is some mint, like they're growing mint in the garden, I do mint and a banana. So do your green, whichever green you have been able to grab, get your hands on, and a banana or whatever fruit you want to use. So you could use half a cup or even a cup of blueberries. Mangoes might be in season, whatever fruit you want, which is going to sweeten your breakfast. And then half a cup of water. Then I add a handful of almonds. So I've got my almonds here. Now this is instead of using almond milk. I don't have a problem with almond milk, but if you're going to be doing this on an ongoing basis, then why not make our own almond milk? So really that's about 12 to 15 almonds and half a cup of water, and therefore you've made your own almond milk and you've got all of the fiber and all of the nutrients in that breakfast. Now, the other thing that I do if I am using the almonds on a daily basis, I will soak them overnight. So as soon as I've made this breakfast, I will put the almonds in some water and just soak them all day. And then in the morning, I drain it, pour boiling water on, wait for about 30 seconds, tip it off, and the skins just pop off, and I use that. That way we're reducing some of the phytates, which are like an anti-nutrient, which can bind to some of the calcium, which means it's not so absorbable. So if you are looking at the almonds as being a calcium source, you do want to soak them overnight. So if that sounds a bit overwhelming, don't do it in the beginning. Just get into the habit of doing this breakfast. So here we go. We've got the green, the fruit, the almonds, and the water, and then we're going to blend that. And this is what I have, and this is how much it makes. I don't use a lot of water because this is still quite runny, and I want it to be sweet. I want to make the most of that, of the banana, from the sweetness or whatever fruit you're using. So now I add some rolled oats. Or you might like to add steel cut oats. So they're even less processed than the rolled oats. If you're starting on this journey and all you've got in the cupboard is quick oats, use some quick oats. Or you might not want to have oats don't have gluten, but they can be triggering for some people. So use buckwheat. You can find that these days. Soak that overnight and add that. And then I might add, where are they? a tablespoon of sunflower seeds or pumpkin seeds, or usually for me, I'm adding the flax seeds, a tablespoon of those ground. And then you've got this amazing breakfast, which sometimes if I've got a busy morning, I will make this the night before and soak, and then it's all soaked and ready to go. And that is just an amazing breakfast, which is economical because oats are economical and they're a great source of fiber. So you've got some healthy fats in there because you've got the almonds and some seeds. You've got a great whole grain in either your oats and your buckwheat. You've got your green in whatever green you've chosen, and you've got some sweetness from some whole fruit. Win, win. So, love to know if that's something that you would like to make, and if you're already making it, comment below, and I'll see you soon. Hey, Caroline.